Right, so today we will open actually a bottle of Domaine de la Romanée Conti, La Tâche, 2012, from Burgundy, so 2012 here. It's one of the most famous wine in the world, and I'm just going to open it like regularly. You turn around, turn around, turn around, and you do a little incision on the side, little incision on the side to basically be able to get the capsule out without damaging it too much, if it's possible. Sometimes it's a bit hard. I'm gonna turn the bottle. I don't normally don't do that, but because there is nobody around, I will do it. So you take off the foil. You see the cork, the top of the cork. There is a little bit of a waxy texture. It's not a big problem. If that was an old vintage, I will use a different type of corkscrew. I will use the Durand, but because this is 2012, it's actually fairly young. It just needs a regular corkscrew. So you try to put it in the middle, and you turn. Okay, once it's here, lift it up a little bit, okay, then second one, and lift it up again, and when it's here, just take your two hands, one to actually block the bottle, the other one to take off the cork, and you can see on the cork, Domaine de la Romanée Conti, La Tâche, 2012, so obviously this is not actually a fake bottle, because everything is there to basically prove that it's the right bottle. You have the waxy texture, you have the capsule is actually good color, the font is good color, the label is actually good as well. So this is a perfectly well preserved, I would say, wine. And now what we're gonna do, the most important things, is we're gonna taste it. So usually you use Burgundy glasses. Burgundy glasses are actually open up to be able for the wine to actually get the maximum of hair. Okay, so I will just do that like this, just in case. So just pour a little bit, just to try it. And so I'll put it back here. Can see the color, beautiful young color. Actually, it's within the range of the ruby, still slightly pinkish purple. It's beautiful. So when you taste the wine, usually you don't want to get too much. You just want to have a quick feeling of it, basically by smelling it. Beautiful aromas like cherry aromas and some earth and some spice, floral scents. Beautiful. Do you want to smell it?
Yes.
Smell it.
Mmm. Ooh.
Like it?
Yeah.
It's beautiful. And once the wine is aerated actually quite enough, like this, you actually try to define if you need to decant it or not. So if it is a Bordeaux, usually Bordeaux are much more tannic and much more tight, I will say, when you open them. So sometimes they need about like 1 or 2 hours to open, and you need a decanter to actually maximize the amount of air in contact with the wine. For Burgundy, it's usually, because it's made with Pinot Noir, it's usually a lighter style type of wine. It's not necessarily less complex, but it's lighter in style, and usually, especially when they're young, they don't necessarily need to actually be decanted. Especially, they don't have any deposit. Some people actually may think that, you know, there's some deposit, but in 2012, there's none. So, once you smell it and you see that it's good, that it's not cork, and that there is no default on the nose, that's beautiful. You can try it. Wow.
So this one is made of Pinot Noir.
This is 100% Pinot Noir, yes, from Monopole. Monopole is actually a single vineyard, and this is 2012. And Domaine de la Romanée Conti is one of the most, you can smell the cork as well, yeah. So the I'm not gonna decant it because it doesn't need to be decanted. I will leave it in the bottle just like this, opening up for the next like 30 minutes or 45 minutes, and then after we will probably start to serve it at some point. I'm gonna leave it here because of the cool atmosphere. But that's about it.
Okay, cool.
When it's a Bordeaux, next time I come, and if we have a Bordeaux, I will teach you how to decant and how to do it differently. Very bright color, not necessarily very deep, not too intense, more on the light reddish ruby with some pink reflection on the hue. And the nose has, after about like 2 hours of opening, has a lot of sherry, bright sherry, great acidity, great freshness on the nose with some floral note, mineral note. There's even some kind of a slight white paperiness to it, almost like a hint of earth as well. It's very, very, very young and bright and juicy. It's not heavy at all. In the palate, it's actually very dry and crisp. It's actually fairly light. I was expecting something a bit more opulent, but it's not. It's actually fairly light and bright, and it's very, very balanced, very, very long finish, and it's super delicate. It's like dancing like a ballerina on your tongue and in the palate. It's beautiful. I love it. Extraordinary wine. Really, really, really well made. Not necessarily as opulent or rich or as complex as I think it would have been, especially after the nose, because the nose is very aromatic. But overall, very enjoyable wine. I really love it personally. But that's about it. That was the description for La Tâche 2012. Very long finish, very balanced, very harmonious, very delicate, like almost like fragile. Love it.